What's up, everybody? My name is Danon, and welcome to Honestly. In my video on how to pick up an Aeron for cheap, a lot of you guys asked me which one do I like better, the classic Aeron or the remastered Aeron. But up to that point, I had actually never sat in a remastered Aeron before. But since then, I managed to get my hands on one, and in this video, I'm going to be doing a quick comparison between the two. But here's the thing, guys, you guys don't need to take my opinion for it, because one lucky winner out there is going to win this set here. This is a basic size B remastered Aeron coupled with the Atlas suspension headrest, which you guys can see the review for over here. And I'm super excited, super stoked about this. I hope you guys are too. Here's the thing though, international friends, this is for US folks only, because to ship this overseas would just cost so much and I just can't afford that right now. So this is for US folks only. To enter, all you have to do is subscribe to this channel and then follow the link in the description below, and that's it. So again, super excited, super stoked to be giving this away. Best of luck to everybody out there. Let's get honest. Okay, so let's start with the price. A brand new remastered Aeron can cost you upwards of $1,500, but we're all about saving money here. So a used remastered Aeron, I have seen go for about $500 to $1,000. $500 being for the basic, $1,000 being for fully loaded. But here's the thing, guys, median Craigslist market price for a fully loaded remastered Aeron is approximately $800. So I would say if you see one that's fully loaded, $800, that is the median price. And from there, every feature you downgrade, subtract $50. And that's that. So if you find a fully loaded remastered Aeron, $800, that's about what you should expect to pay. If it's cheaper than that, then that's a good deal, and so on and so on. For the classic Aeron, I've seen these things go from about $150 to $600, $150 being for the basic and $600 being for the high end. But right now I'm seeing that the median price for a fully loaded Aeron with the tab switches, which if you guys have seen my other video, you know what I'm talking about, a fully loaded with the tab Aeron is about $450. So again, if you see a fully loaded with the posture fit and the tabs, $450, that's about average price. And then if you can find one lower than that, then that's a good price, and so on and so on. Every feature you downgrade, again, subtract $50. So the chairs should range around from $150 to $450. So these two chairs differ in four areas: their mesh, the seat pan, the lumbar support, and the aesthetics. Other than that, these two chairs are really similar. So when it comes to the features, they're exactly the same, and they work in that three-tier system. So for example, the arms, basic is static, second level is up and down, third level is up and down and swivel left and right. The lumbar comes in three phases, just like the classic did, and then the back tilt and then the forward tilt, that's the same thing just like the classic Aeron. So just those four areas are different. Again, it's the mesh, the seat pan, the lumbar support, and the aesthetics. So starting with the mesh, Herman Miller has upgraded their mesh on the remastered Aerons, and I'm not gonna get into all their marketing BS. I'm just gonna tell you guys what it feels like, and it feels amazing. I mean, it really does feel so good. The bottom is really taut, but I can't tell if that's because it's newer than my current Aeron here, but the back, there's a huge difference. It just feels like it's hugging my spine. I mean, it is wonderful. This is a basic Aeron. It doesn't even have lumbar support, and yet it feels really, really, really good. So huge, huge thumbs up to Herman Miller for this upgraded, improved mesh. Next up is the seat pan. On the remastered Aeron, they made the seat pan shorter, and I could be crazy, but I think the angle at which it dips down is steeper versus the classic, which is longer. And again, I feel like the dip down is a little bit less steep. And on the classic Aeron, there is actually a pad under here. And by the way, if you guys ever go to pick up an Aeron, a classic Aeron, make sure you guys check under here for that padding and make sure it hasn't disintegrated, because for some reason it does, it falls apart. And if they do, ask for like a $50 discount, because that thing only costs $20. So another way to save money. Because this seat pan on the remastered is shorter, I feel like you sit naturally a little bit more upright than you do in this one. Because it's a little longer, I feel like you fall back into this one versus this chair, you sit a little bit more upright. So if you're somebody who likes to lean back in your chair, you might like the classic Aeron better. If you're someone who likes a more proper upright seating position, you probably will like the remastered a little bit better. I will tell you that I have short legs, and because of that, my angle of which my leg bends happens faster than I think other folks. And because of that, when I tuck my legs back on my chair, I feel the plastic on my calf pretty heavily. On the remastered one though, I don't feel it as much, and so it's much more comfortable for short legs. So again, people with short legs out there, holla at me. The remastered Aeron is probably gonna feel better on your calves. Next up is the lumbar support, and I need to spend a little bit more time here because it does get a little bit confusing even for me. Let me know if I make a mistake here for those of you guys who know a little bit better. But Herman Miller basically upgraded the lumbar support on the remastered Aerons, but they did it twice. So the first time they released their remastered Aerons, they had the mid-level lumbar support, which I can't show you guys here. I'll show you guys a picture where it's kind of like a bar, but with a football looking thing in the middle. And then they had their upgraded lumbar support, which looked like it's a football hanging from two wires in the middle of your back. But Herman Miller realized that, hey, that might not give you the support that you want. And then they created this thing called the PostureFit SL, which is what you see in most images, which looks like a football and then a old school telephone on your back, and it presses there. And because this is a basic Aeron, I have never used that before, but it looks like it would feel amazing. I mean, already the mesh feels wonderful. I can only imagine that thing feels great. But here's some things that you should know. You guys can buy a remastered mid-tier lumbar support separately. So if you wanted that, the bar equivalent of the classic lumbar support, it's gonna cost you $90, and I think you can slide it down the tabs just like you would do it on the classic lumbar bar. The upgraded PostureFit SL, however, you cannot install yourself. If you want that, you have to take out the entire pan and replace it with one that has that PostureFit SL installed, and that's gonna run you about $260 US. So that's for the remastered Aeron. For the classic, you guys know that it has the bar, that rubber bar, which is pretty good, totally adjustable in terms of height. You really gotta know what you're doing because you could hurt yourself, or you could cause yourself more discomfort. Sorry, hurting yourself is a little bit dramatic, but you could cause a little bit more discomfort until you figure out the right position. And then this is the upgraded PostureFit, not the SL, but regular PostureFit, which provides you a little bit more support on just the bottom of your spine, which a lot of people weren't happy about. So the new one provides you more range, vertical range of lumbar support versus the classic one. The upgraded PostureFit only provides support on that bottom part of the spine. I wish I could give you guys more details on how the different lumbars felt on the remastered, but unfortunately I just don't have that one here with me. Let me know in the comments below how good it is, if you guys like it, and what your guys' thoughts are. The last difference is going to be in the aesthetics, particularly in the bottom housing where your adjustments are located for the rear tilt limiter and the forward tilt limiter. In the classic one, it's going to look more like a box engine, like a really boxy contraption. In the new one, it looks like a spaceship, really sleek. And then in the classic one, in order to back tilt, to get the back tilt and the forward tilt limiter, you use tabs, whereas in the remastered, you use knobs, which is kind of cool. The other thing is that for the tension knob, for the tightness knob, for how easily you can rock back, on the classic version, you would have to turn that 1,000 times and have Popeye forearms before you would see a difference in tension. On the remastered Aerons, if you turn it 3 times, you get to a point where you couldn't even rock yourself back if you wanted to. So a lot more effective, happens a lot quicker, your forearms don't get as tired. And then the other aesthetic difference, well, it's more aesthetic than anything, is that they used a lot more metal on the classic Aerons than on the remastered ones. So on the bottom, it's all metal, versus on the classic or remastered, it's all plastic down here. So I guess that's an aesthetic difference. Okay, so my final thoughts. I really, really like the remastered Aeron, to the point where I'm seriously regretting giving it away. Whoever wins this, I hate you so much. Just kidding, I really like it. And I'll put it this way. If you can find a remastered Aeron for about the same price that you would pick up a fully loaded classic Aeron, I think you should strongly consider the remastered Aeron. Like, that's how much I like it. As a matter of fact, I'll say this. If you can find a basic Aeron with fully loaded arms, because the fully loaded arms to me is actually the most critical upgrade I think you need on this chair. If you can find that kind of chair for about the same price as a fully loaded classic or a little bit more expensive, you should definitely 1000% pick the remastered Aeron. That's how much I love it. That's how much I think the mesh makes a huge difference. The seat pan makes a huge difference. The lumbar, again, if the mesh doesn't do it for you, wait a little bit. $90 is expensive, but later on, it doesn't feel as expensive if you were to upgrade that with the mid-tier lumbar support. So I think you could swing that a little bit later. But yeah, I mean, that's how much I like the remastered Aeron. And again, if the prices were all the same, I would pick a remastered Aeron. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. Am I crazy? Value proposition? Am I nuts? Maybe I'm just a hype beast. Let me know again in the comments below. Best of luck to everybody out there. Again, all you have to do to enter the giveaway for this set here is you just have to subscribe and then follow the link in the description below. That's going to do it for this one, guys. Until next time, stay safe. And as always, stay honest.